Well, college basketball is about to bring an even bigger boost to Indiana now that the state will host the entire NCAA tournament. Officials say the economic impact could bring some desperately needed help to struggling businesses. CBS Sports' Lexa Green has more from the NCAA headquarters and how the tournament will work.
Well, it's not going to be easy. NCAA officials tell us the planning is already underway to make sure all 68 teams can safely play and stay here in the Hoosier State. The tournament is going to use hotels in Indy and some of the surrounding areas. At least four hotels in Indy will be bubble hotels, meaning only the players and staff will stay there. No outside guests will be allowed in. Economic impact is estimated to be in the nine-figure range, with 2,500 hotel rooms set aside for teams, media, and other officials. The JW Marriott is one of those hotels. The manager says all safety precautions will be followed and teams will have their own spaces.
And what that means is we're actually going to be closed to the public, and virtually almost all the floors will have teams on it. So each team would get a floor. We make sure our staff is temperature checked and properly screened before they come to work.
The Indiana Restaurant and Lodging Association says roughly two-thirds of Indiana hotels are facing bankruptcy. The hope is that this tournament can help some of the areas gain enough business to make it through the next few months, which is typically some of the hardest times in the hospitality industry. Now, another question a lot of people have been asking, will fans be allowed at some of these games? So far, NCAA officials say they're not certain at this point and say a decision will be made at a later date. That's the latest downtown. Alexa Green, we'll send it back to you in the studio.
All right.